The Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. Welcome to the first unpopular opinions video of the year, where I piss you off and you come back anyway because you love me and you miss me. And no interesante, motherfuckers, y'all gonna come back anyway. Okay, now first things first, I broke a nail at TikTok's Black History event, so reward, and I lost my voice, so damn it. Disregard. Jesus Christ, I have to be in the studio tomorrow and I think I'm gonna have to reschedule because my voice is still going and I'm sitting here filming videos. This is literally my fifth one in one day. And I just was like, yeah, this is not helping. But like, it goes in and out. Like when I try to talk in my regular voice, I sound like this. But when I talk a little deeper, it sounds a little better, but it's not helping. But anyways, let's get straight into the unpopular opinions now, shall we? First unpopular opinion. Pumping gas is ghetto as fuck. Now listen, I say this from privilege because I live in New Jersey where we do not pump gas. We have gas attendants. And I kid you not, I was probably a year or 2 years old when I found out that other motherfuckers have to pump their own gas. I was so perplexed. I was like, why doesn't everybody have gas attendants? Like, like one of my cousins tried to teach me how to pump gas and I was just like, this is crazy. Like, I am too pretty to be pumping gas. Like, that is crazy. Like, if I ever move out of state, I'm gonna be really confused and really sad. Like, because I'm not pumping my own gas. Like, that's crazy. Like, I'm not doing that, bro. I feel like everybody in other states should rally around and be like, hey, yo, we do not want to pump our own gas. Like, first of all, having gas attendants creates jobs. Second of all, Ivana doesn't want to pump her own gas. Third of all, it be hot and shit. Like, niggas don't, why would you want to pump your own gas? Pumping your own gas is ghetto, bruh. Ridiculous. Why? Just why? I've already talked about this on my Haitian channel, but we're gonna talk about this right here, right now. The Biden migration parole program is fucking stupid, okay? If you guys are not aware, here's a quick little preference. Biden is out here letting all these migrants from all these different places come to America for 2 years on a work visa, but you have to know someone here in order for them to do it for you. I've talked about this again on my other channel. I'll link the video down below. But this specific Biden parole program is for Haitian, Venezuelans, and I believe Nicaraguan. I think, whatever, it's three specific countries, and I feel like it is enabling people to leave their country so that America could take over and use these three countries for their resources, their land, and to put bases over there so they can use these countries for their advantages, just like China's out here taking over all these African countries and all these other countries are being used by these elitist countries for their own interests. Okay, so personally, I think that migration is a beautiful thing, right? And I feel like people, if you know you have the resources and you have the money and you are able to help people 100%, 1000%, then yeah, bring people if you want to, if you can. But like, if you know damn well you're gonna bring people to America to be sleeping on the floor, sleeping in bed with you, sleeping in the fucking kitchen, sleeping in the bathtub, don't be fucking bringing people here. I said what the fuck I said. Okay, if you have children that are intolerant and they're not gonna be nice to your family and your friends that you bring here, don't bring people here. You want food stamps, don't bring people here. You want Section 8, don't bring people here, because you're not gonna be able to take care of that. You feel some type of way? Oh well. Having no friends is actually not a flex. I could never understand people that like literally be out here like, you know, I'm lonely. Fuck bitches. Fuck niggas. I'll be by myself. I'll be on my lonesome and I don't give a fuck. I never needed bitches. Never needed niggas ever. Like, yeah. Like, that's cool and all, but like, why do y'all feel so damn like happy to go around saying that you have no friends? Like, listen, it's not a flex to be out here being friends with like everybody. Like, you friends with him, her, them, whatever. The cat, the rats. Like, it's not a flex to be friends with everyone, but like, it's not okay to be flexing that like no one trusts you, no one fucks with you, and you an op. Like, that is weird. Like, I don't see what is so great about telling any and everyone that no one trusts you, no one fucks with you, you have fallouts with everyone every 2 seconds, and that you have no friends. Like, what is so great about that? And of course, you're not gonna ever have any friends at that point, because everybody's gonna be like, oh, well, damn, what's wrong with him? What's wrong with her that they can't keep a friend? And y'all be the main ones like, oh, everybody fake, everybody phony, everybody. Well, yeah, because you're going around telling everybody that you ain't shit at that point. You're basically a walking poster of ain't shitness. Stop that shit. You're weird. I know we all grew up with the jumping people is whack. It's not okay to jump people, but jumping people sometimes is acceptable. Okay, sometimes some people need to get the message. Okay, now if you guys did not watch my 12 days of story time this year, you need to go watch it. What the fuck are you doing? Okay, it's on my third channel. That's where I do all the story times and the personal content now. Don't think I stopped doing it because I always got a motherfucking story. It's just on that channel now. But anyways, I talked about how this one girl, but a couple of girls in my friend group in high school let my ass get jumped, so I jumped their ass. Yeah, I don't give a fuck. Sometimes jumping is acceptable, okay? Like, some bitches need to get the message. And yeah, I could have shot the fade, but my thing is, you let me get jumped, so I'ma need you to see how you let me feel. You feel me? So you gonna get this work. I was like 15 at the time. Yeah, I'm 28 and I still feel the same way, and that might be a problem. But I don't give a fuck. I said what I said, I meant what I said, and I'll say it again. Sometimes it's acceptable to jump a bitch. Don't kill them though. Don't stop on their head or nothing, you know. I ain't say all of that. But sometimes they have to get the message, you feel me? And that brings me to my next one. You don't always have to be politically correct. Sometimes you have some toxic opinions, and that's okay. It is what it is. Cheating is not part of the growing pains of a relationship. Say it with me. Cheating is not part of the growing pains of a relationship. I don't know, Depikile, since when we started uttering this bullshit. I don't know if it's the older generation. It probably is the older generation. Your mom, your aunt, your grandma, all of these dumb ass bitches sat here telling y'all it's okay to accept the man cheat. Men are always gonna cheat. Boys will be boys. Might as well let him cheat in peace because men are always gonna do what they gonna do. Men are always looking for other women. Good men are too hard to come by, and good men are always going to do what they do because there's not that many of them and we gotta share them. Shut the fuck up. Do not believe that shit. Oh my god. Cheating is not part of the growing pains of oh my god. Ladies and gentlemen, if you think that you have to accept someone cheating in order to be with them just because they're good and they're so good and you have to share them, I guarantee you, you're in a warped state of mind. You do not have to accept someone cheating in order to have a happy relationship. You also do not have to shut up about someone cheating on you just because they happen to be a great person and you're never gonna find a better person than that, so you might as well just suck it up and charge it to the game. Especially when it comes to men. We just sit here and let men do whatever the fuck they want because boys will be boys. No, shut up. Kill that noise. Do not just let men walk all over you because you think you're never gonna get a good one, because a good man is hard to come by. People just use that excuse, and then men just keep doing this shit because women let them. Do not do that. Put your foot down. Speak up for yourself. And that brings me to my next point. It is impossible to get over physical cheating. A little flirting here and there, a little straying from the relationship, I feel like maybe you can get over. But once you physically cheat, I don't feel like there's anything you could do to get back from that. There's always gonna be one person in that relationship that's like, damn, this person literally had sex with a whole nother person. Like, what was going on in that room? What did I do that made this person go to another person? Will they do it again? Are they thinking about that other person when they were with me? I just don't think it's possible. I could personally never ever like get past someone having sex with a whole nother person. Kissing is one thing, flirting is another thing, like shit like that. Yeah, I think maybe, but like, I feel like when someone has physical sex with a whole nother, like when it gets physical to that point, it's like, no, I don't think you're fixing that relationship. That's just my personal opinion. People from Philly get on my nerves with this whole new fake ass, is it called Brill? I don't know, I'm probably saying it completely wrong. This whole situation that they think that they started this Jersey club sounding music is a fucking lie. They think that they started club music, okay? All of this new music that they're putting out there that sounds like Jersey Club, and they're trying to make dances that look just like our dances that we've been doing since we're like fucking five, is a fucking joke. It makes me so fucking angry that I just wanna fucking like hit something, bro. Like, these people, bro, oh my god. People from Philly are out here putting out music that sounds exactly like fucking Jersey Club music and trying to make it sound like it's their own fucking genre of music, when literally they're recycling Jersey Club music and making it sound like their own shit, when it's literally exactly like Jersey Club music. The dances are the same, the music is the same, the production level is the same, except ours is better. And it's like, boy, we've been doing the same shit forever. You could literally go on YouTube and search up Jersey Club, and you'll see us doing the sexy walk, the patty cake, the running man, go skiing, all of this shit, and it looks just like their dances, and they're just naming it something else. Get the fuck out of here. That's our shit, period. What is this, Philly broil? Come on, really. What's more annoying about it is, when I used to dance at Jersey Club all the time, like in middle school and shit like that, niggas used to look at us like we was weird. Like, I would go to other places, play my little Jersey Club music, kill my little sexy walk, do my little patty cake, whatever. Niggas used to be like, oh, what the fuck is that? What the fuck are you listening to? Now everybody's, It's like, no, bitch. Because we was weird. We was weird, remember that? We was weird. What is this? Oh, that's Brill. No, it's not. Oh, that's Philly. No, it's not. I don't give a fuck what it is. I don't give a fuck what it's called. It's probably a whole different name because everybody just wants to bite off each other and all this extra shit and call it something else. My thing is, give credit where it's due. It's crazy because this became like a whole argument like on Facebook or whatever, because like these niggas really were like in interviews like, oh, nah, we don't dance like them. We don't dance like niggas from Jersey. It's the Jersey fucking dances and you guys are renaming them. Stop that chat. This one will get y'all upset. But it has to be said, Jeffree Star was right. So if you guys are not aware, Jeffree Star came out recently saying that the whole they them situation is ridiculous, and I'm sorry, but it kind of is. Hear me out, right? The thing is, if you tell me what you want to be called, I'll just call you it out of respect. But I really can't stand when people tell me to call them they them, because I genuinely can't remember it, and personally that is not a thing. Either you're he or you're she, in my opinion, or you're an it, because that's an inanimate object, right? But it's just like that whole they them thing just doesn't make sense to me. And I never heard of the they them thing until I think I just got out of college, and I had a coworker that wanted to be addressed as they them. I think they were non-binary, I forgot what they were, and I tried my hardest, but honestly I kept slipping up. First of all, it was the first time I ever heard of someone being non-binary, and honestly I just could not remember. And the person presented as a boy, so I just kept calling him he, and he got so fucking upset at me every single time. And I'm like, listen, I completely understand that you want to be referred to as they and them, but you present to me as a boy. So it's just very frustrating that you want me to address you as they and them, but you're presenting to me as a she or he. And then on top of that, what I really don't like about the trans community lately, okay, I've done a lot of reactions on the trans community, is that the trans community doesn't even respect us, is their blatant disrespect for the heterosexual community, right? They sit here calling us cisgendered, and we keep saying we do not want to be called cis, okay? But then they're like, oh no, you have to be called cis because it's a scientific term. And it's like, well, if you want me to call you they and them, I don't want to be called cis. Like, I literally had that whole argument with somebody not too long ago, and it's like, if you want me to call you they them, that's fine, but then don't call me cis. And they're like, well, I'm still gonna call you cis. And I'm like, then I'm gonna call you he. I don't understand. Like, I have no problem calling you a woman because that's what you present as, even though I know you were born a man. I'm gonna call you a woman because that's what you want me to call you, but then don't call me cis. I don't understand. Like, it just doesn't make sense. It's like, it's the blatant disrespect, right? And it's like, I've been more than respectful, okay? I've literally sat here and reacted to trans women dragging the fuck out of black women on this channel, and I still sat here and been respectful as hell. Now, I know a lot of you guys are probably like, oh, well, that doesn't mean you disrespect the whole whatever of people that want to be called they them. That's the thing, I'm not saying that, but I feel like the they them sometimes can take it a lot, because it's like, bro, that's hard. Like, if you're presenting yourself as a man, I'm gonna call you a man. If you're presenting yourself as a woman, I'm gonna call you a woman. And if you tell me, oh, I want to be they, I want to be them, I will do that, but you have to tell me that. I've seen people get like real real upset. Like, oh, how do you know I'm a man? How do you know I'm a woman? It's like, bitch, you got a fucking wig on and a skirt on. You telling me that you want to be an it, a dog, a whale? I don't fucking know that, you know? I feel like it has a lot to do with how people, like, present it. And of course, what you look like. But, like, I remember when it first got brought up to me, I was just like, what the fuck are you talking about? And then I tried, and then the person still got mad at me. And it's just like, it's too much. I really do want people to be comfortable, especially during their journeys. But at the same time, it's like a lot of them are very disrespectful to us. Like, a lot of them don't even respect hetero people, you know? Every time we want something or don't want to do something or have a concern about something, it's, oh, you motherfucking da da da, you guys are, it's like, bro, it's too much. It's like, we conform to your needs, but you guys can't conform to ours. And every time we have a concern or a complaint, we're whining, we're this, we're judgy, we're disrespectful. And it's like, bro, like, it's getting a lot. I never thought I would agree with Jeffree Star, but here I am. Not everyone needs to be a creator. It's very weird being an influencer, because back in the day, being an influencer or a creator, like, or just making funny little videos online was kind of embarrassing, right? Like, remember how, like, back in the day, if you wanted to be like a YouTuber or something like that, like, kind of like hid it from people, like, you didn't want to be like, hey guys, I have a YouTube channel, watch it. Like, you kind of like, oh, let me just go make this video, I hope no one finds my YouTube channel, because then they're gonna make fun of me. Now it's like, oh my god, you're a YouTuber, like, how did you get your subscribers? Like, oh my god, how did you get your followers on Instagram? Like, not everybody wants to be a creator, everybody wants to know how you did it, everybody wants to tea, everybody wants to sauce, everybody wants to do what you do. And it's weird, because before it was kind of embarrassing to do what I do. Now I'm out here getting invited to career days, hopping on panels, and it's like, all right, okay. And what's even more interesting is, like, now everyone kind of has a following or is trying to build a following. And I think it's because everyone kind of pushes this glamorous lifestyle. Oh, I make $10,000 a month. Oh, I make $10,000 a week. Oh, I do this, I do that. I'm with this. I'm living la vida loca. All this extra shit. And it's just like, do you guys not understand that, like, you don't have to be a creator to be successful or to make that much money? Like, there's so many other career paths. And it's like, because I made a whole video about that and people were so upset. And it's like, it's the truth though. There's so many other career paths. And even being a creator, there's so many other career paths you could be other than a creator. You could work for a company and be an influencer liaison or an influencer marketing strategist. You can literally handle a company's social media and make so much money and be a creator, or just use your creator connects or your creator talent while managing a company social media, you know? So it's like, there's so many things you could do other than being a creator. You know, you can be a videographer because you have so much work working with a camera, stuff like that. You can be a photographer. There's so many things. It's like, why does everybody want to be a creator? And then it's funny because when they start creating, they realize, oh shit, there's a lot more work than I thought. It's not just posting and going. Damn, you have to plan a video, you have to research the video, you have to do the thumbnails, you have to do the promotion, you have to do the community management. You have to promote it. You have to promote yourself. You have to go to the events. You have to network. Child, there's so much shit that goes into this. And it's just like, people really be thinking we just be posting and going. Like, I've literally, this week when I went to the TikTok shit, niggas were talking about something. Yeah, it takes me 13 hours to edit a fucking TikTok video. I'm like, these 1 minute videos take you 13 hours? Bitch, let me stay my ass on YouTube. It takes me 2 hours and now I have an assistant. So it takes me zero. Like, bitch, fuck out of here. Like, man, I don't got time for that. It is not cops' jobs to be heroes. It never really makes sense to me how a lot of people be like, oh, why didn't the cops do something? Why didn't the cops intervene? Why didn't the cops stop the fight? Y'all do know that cops aren't supposed to be heroes, right? Like, they're not necessarily supposed to put their lives on the line unless they, like, necessarily want to. Yeah, they're supposed to serve and protect, but they're not supposed to serve and commit suicide. Like, that is not their job. And I don't even think that's an unpopular opinion. That's legitimately a fact. Like, this is why, like, a lot of times when you call the cops, all they do is come and file a report, okay? This is why when something's happening, you are not gonna see cops literally break up a fight. They're gonna wait till the fight ends and then they're gonna come and be like, okay, so what happened here? Okay, well, so you're getting arrested and you're this or that or whatever the case may be, because it's not their job to put their life at risk to save your dumb ass from doing some stupid shit or they dumb ass from going this, that, and the third. This is why when that whole situation happened with that school shooting, they all just stood outside because there's an active shooter in that building. Why the fuck would they go in there guns blazing with guns blazing at them? It just doesn't make sense. Like, yeah, they're cops, but they're not bulletproof. What do you expect them to do it? They're not God. They're not God, guys. Like, a lot of people forget that. Like, the cops are here to mitigate. You go, they're here to stop things from happening, but not necessarily put their lives in danger to stop things from happening, if that makes sense. And that brings me to my next point. Teachers are not your children's second parents. Yeah, kids are in school all day, every day, and they're supposed to be learning in school. However, you're supposed to do the work as a parent. You're supposed to still teach your kids life skills. You're supposed to continue the education in the home when the kid comes home. You're supposed to still tutor the child. You're supposed to still read to the child. You're supposed to still teach the kid whatever the kid does not learn at school. It is not the school or the teacher's job to teach the child every single thing there is to know in life. I don't understand why it is that some kids literally come to fucking school not fucking knowing their own name. I know this because I've witnessed it, okay? I'm currently a dance teacher and I be seeing some interesting kids in other classes. I be coming across some interesting children. And it's just like, do these parents not read with their kids or do anything with their kids when they leave? believe, because it's just like, why is this happening? Why is this a thing? A lot of y'all be thinking, oh, well, if my kid is here from 7 to 6, they should be learning more than whatever it is they're coming home with. And it's like, yes, in theory, but you're still a parent. You signed up for this job. You still have to be a fucking parent. Yeah, you're busy. Yeah, you're tired. Yeah, your kid is not with you for most of the time, but the time that you have with your kid, you still have to make it worth it. You still have to be a parent. Men deserve the right to defend themselves. Meaning, I'm not saying men should beat the shit out of women when women get out of line. I'm not saying that shit, okay? But I'm saying it is insanely unfair that women be out here slapping the shit out of men, doing whatever the hell it is that they want to men when they're upset. But the moment a man restrains a woman, she can go to the courthouse and be like, oh, he beat me, ah, and the man goes to jail. That's not okay. I feel like men should be able to defend themselves, not like knock the bitch the fuck out. However, women, y'all can't be out here putting y'all hands on a scary ass man and not expecting him to defend himself. Expect men to defend themselves. And expect, if you're gonna slap the shit out of a man, he might be able to restrain you and pin you up against the wall. Expect him to be able to probably hit your ass back. Probably not as hard as he can, but hit your ass back. It makes absolutely no sense that people be out here just hitting the fuck out of men, doing whatever the fuck, but she will not be held to the fullest extent of law than he would if roles were reversed. Again, I don't think that men should be out here blacking a bitch eye and doing, like, no, but I feel like men should definitely be able to defend themselves if they are attacked by a woman, okay? Point blank, period. I don't think it should be at the same force, but they should be able to defend themselves, and women should be held accountable by law if they do put their hands on men, because I feel like the law is disproportionate in that realm. My final one is these specified black creator programs on these social media platforms are problematic. I'm actually gonna do maybe a dedicated video on this. I'm not even sure. I might just like drop it, who knows. But what I'm talking about is like TikTok black, YouTube black. There's probably even a Facebook black and an Instagram black. I'm not even sure, because I'm not part of that and I don't know anybody that's part of it. But so I recently been invited to YouTube black, things like that. And I did talk about how I think it is necessary for black creators to have these things, because, you know, it shows that we're appreciated. It shows that, you know, the platforms do care about all of the things that we have put into the platforms. And it does show all the growth, the effort, and the creativity that we have put into the platform, shit like that, right? However, I have realized that there is such a class divide within these platforms, okay? And any creator that is part of these platforms would know exactly what I'm talking about. From the outside looking in, you wouldn't be able to see it. You guys would probably just look at it as, oh, okay, YouTube black, okay, Instagram black, whatever. But like, I'd have to make a whole dedicated video on this. I'll probably talk about this on my Patreon, I'm not sure, but like, there's a lot that goes into it. Like, there's only certain people invited to certain events, and there's certain levels of events within these things. Like, there's certain higher tier events, there's certain perks that you get within certain ranks of these things, and I think it's kind of unfair. Like, we already have this crabs in a barrel mentality within the black community, and I feel like a lot of these platforms perpetuate the crabs in a barrel mentality by having these programs and then having ranks within these programs. Like, they'll have like an overall event, but then they'll have like another event and another event within the event within an event, where certain people of certain levels are invited to certain things that other people are not invited to. It's like, oh, you can't sit at this table, but you can sit at that table, and we'll let you know if you're invited to that plane. Oh, you didn't know there was a plane? Oh yeah, that's because you're finally invited to that hotel. Oh, you didn't know there was that hotel? Oh, that's because you weren't invited to the cruise. Oh, you weren't invited to the cruise. It's like, nigga, we all black and I thought we was on this program. It's like, it's shit like that, and I feel like it's kind of reinforcing the crabs in a barrel mentality. And I feel like low-key it's kind of giving problematic, okay? Like, a lot. With that being said, that was my last unpopular opinion, and I think that's my last video for today, because my voice is really starting to give out. Getting real, real soft. I'm in my soft girl era. Let me shut the fuck up and stop talking about that damn shit. Oh man, the girls were so upset when I talked about the soft girl era. Man, yeah. But yeah, it's time to get the fuck out of here. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope I didn't piss you guys so much that you guys unsubscribed or something, but you'll be back. With that being said, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. Please subscribe to the other two channels. My main channel, which is this channel. My Haitian channel, which deals with Haitian politics, voodoo, folklore, as well as growing up Haitian American. And my personal channel, where I do vlogs, stories, story times, advice videos, things like that, please join the Patreon. Shout out to all the patrons. Thank you so much for being on there. I do post early uploads. I plan on doing personal dedicated uploads on there. I do a monthly live, things like that. And if you guys enjoyed The Mafia Speaks, that is on my third channel. And if you guys are on the Patreon, you can come up there with me. So yeah, I think I'm done. Bye now.